Okay, so the final temple, thankfully, I am overheating. I am running out of, I'm seriously overheating. Not doing so great. But I'll get through this temple and then back to the hotel. So probably a little too much in this heat. Five temples in 5, 6 hours. A lot of walking in 40 plus degree heat and 100% humidity. It just it's too much, especially for a guy from Canada not used to the heat. So anyway, this is the famous Tomb Raider temple, or Tap Prohm as they call it, which is also the name of my hotel. So we'll go take a look, guys, and see what all the hubbub's about. So everywhere you look, there's these holes in all the different stones. So I'm not sure what that is for. I have to find somebody, a guide, and ask them if that's part of the building process, or they put poles for a ceremony. I don't know. So we'll have to find out. Okay, well, let's see what this temple has in store. Some of it's off limits, fair enough. Well, there's the famous scene from Tomb Raider with the tree in the background there. So I can say I've seen it, I'll go up and touch it, and knock it off my bucket list. No, I cannot touch it because it's all fenced off. But that's it. This is Tomb Raider Temple. We'll go look inside here. It looks pretty cool. So there you go. That's what it looks like.
Canada.
looks pretty cool in here. Looks like it's hasn't deteriorated much, unless they've repaired a lot of it, but it's in pretty good shape, if you ask me. Well, I'm no scientist, but based on my limited science knowledge, this rubble must have been come down a long time ago, because this tree and its roots are well over this rubble. So, and those trees are pretty freaking tall. So, I imagine this all collapsed a long time ago, and the trees that came after. That's my scientific theory. That roof looks amazing. Look at the detail work on that. Looks like there's been some repair up there. Some of the rock doesn't, or the stone don't match. So I imagine they've done some repair. This is a nice, cool, pretty cool temple. Looks good.
Thank you.
Yeah, this is it. I'm gonna go through this way. Thank you. So welcome to Prohm part two. So I was here yesterday, near closing. Couldn't finish it. It just got too hot, too tired, and like I said, it was near closing. So came back after Angkor Wat, and kind of finished looking around this temple. This is the famous temple from Tomb Raider, Angelina Jolie. It's one where they have the trees like growing into the wall into the temple. It's the famous video or their classic picture of the tree growing on the walls on the far side. So I'll take you guys over there in a minute. We're just in a different courtyard here. So I look around here. So it's pretty amazing though. Lots of stones here that are still remnants, I guess, of the temple that have fallen apart, basically fallen apart. And they've collected all the stones, and I guess they'll at some point reconstruct part of it. There's part of the wall there. It's a pretty neat. I like this temple. It's one of my favorites because it's just sort of the jungle sort of overtaking it a bit. So all the other ones are sort of cleared of the jungle, but this one, they let the jungle do its thing, so it's kind of cool. Let's see what's up here. These all look like volcanic rock almost. I can't get in there, but looks like it's jungle's overgrown that as well. That's cool because you can see all these marks at all the temples you've gone to that I've seen. You can see these marks here, and I imagine those are ancient tool marks, whatever they were using back then, to sort of carve and shape the stone. And then some parts obviously are super smooth where they do their relief work, I guess. The I don't know what they call it, hieroglyphics or something. But all the patterns and designs and in the stonework. So but this is a cool. This is one of the cooler ones. If you get a chance, definitely come see Angkor Wat, the big one. And then this is Taprom, Taphom or something, Taprom. But definitely get a chance to go see this one. I'm staying low, guys, because there's bats above me, and they're starting to get dust because there's dirt and going through these little holes here. It's not a very big opening, so I'm standing in the way. The bats will be flying into me or past me. So I'm staying low. Really don't want to get bit or scratched by a bat in the middle of the jungle in Cambodia. So, but this particular temple, full of bats. Prohm. Thank you. All right, new closing, guys. This is Prohm Temple. One of the good things about coming to the temple near closing is there's nobody here. So I've got this whole place to myself. There's no throngs of tourists. Oh, did I hear somebody? Thought I heard somebody. So unlike Angkor Wat, where there's hundreds and hundreds of tourists, I'm at the Prohm Temple near closing. It is probably close to 5:30, pushing 6, and I have this all to myself. So that's a little pro tip for you. If you come here, try and come here near the closing time. Get in before they close and then hang out after they close. You know, place to yourself at sunset. That's pretty cool.